Food prices have been facing meteoric rises recently, but they are about to go even higher because the United States agricultural production is being absolutely devastated by what is being considered the worst drought in all American history. This week, the latest reading of the U.S. Drought Monitor brought some extremely concerning news for us. The state of California is now 100% in state of drought, and given that California produces over 60% of the vegetables, fruits, and nuts Americans consume all across the country, this is a major indicator that we will see food shortages and soaring food prices once again in the next couple of months. Evidently, California isn't the only state facing a nightmarish drought right now. Extremely dry weather conditions are covering more territory in our western states than we have ever seen before. The latest data showed that 100% of all states west of the Rocky Mountains and most of the upper Midwest region are experiencing some level of drought. Apart from California, Oregon, Arizona, Idaho, Utah, and North Dakota were also nearly 100% severe drought or worse. While Washington, Montana, South Dakota, Minnesota, New Mexico, most of Wyoming, and western Colorado are all in moderate to worse drought. Scorching hot temperatures in the Pacific Northwest and other parts of the West Coast, along with extended drought in those areas and the upper Midwest, are put at risk millions of acres of crops and livestock, raising concerns about whether there will be enough water for irrigation supplies in the region. Even though 2020 was one of the worst years for agricultural production in the U.S., at this time last year, only 20% of the West was suffering from severe drought. Today, that number jumped to a staggering 80%. What we're facing here is a historic disaster of unprecedented proportions. And our nation's farmers and ranchers and our food supply chains will be dramatically hit hard by this crisis. In fact, the agricultural production of some supplies is already dwindling at an alarming rate. For instance, the USDA is forecasting that the amount of spring wheat will drop by 41% from 2020, marking the lowest level since 1988. The report exposed that the average yield was forecast at 30.7 bushels an acre, down 37% from 2020 and the lowest since 2002. Although 2021 spring wheat planted area was down 5.5% from 2020, the harvested area was down 7%, suggesting a larger number of abandoned acres. The truth is that all organic grains, which tend to be grown in concentrated areas, some of which are located in major drought regions, are in a particularly critical situation at the moment. Oat crops are being hit even harder. According to Bloomberg, the U.S. oat crop will be the smallest that we have seen since records began in 1866. Yep, you heard that right. We're about to record the smallest harvest in nearly two centuries. The 2021 U.S. harvest is currently estimated at 41.3 million bushels. That's from data from the Department of Agriculture, they told us Monday. The outlook is significantly down from the agency's June projection of about 53 million bushels. For our nation's hundreds of thousands of farmers, this year is going to be exceedingly painful. Many farmers are predicting there will be little to no production to harvest in the coming months. At Schiefelbein Farms in Minnesota, by this time of the year, the hay field should already be knee-high, but instead, it's sparse, barely ankle-high. The farm owners project that they will have roughly 75% less hay this year. Out of the 2,500 acres of corn they planted, they'll not be able to harvest hardly anything. In Texas, farmer and rancher Ross Copeland urged for help from the House Committee on Natural Resources, stressing that there have been many factors over the years making it increasingly difficult to continue farming and ranching, Copeland told the lawmakers. However, severe drought is one of the largest issues we face. For over 50 years, Copeland and his family have been in the agricultural business. They raise cattle and sheep and grow crops in Coke, Sterling, Scurry, and San Saba counties. He's seen cracked ground quite a lot throughout his life, and the feeling of desperation for the next rain isn't new to him. However, this year's desperation has hit a whole new level, and severe drought conditions are forcing Copeland to reevaluate whether it's still financially viable to stay in the business over the next couple of years. He revealed the worsening drought made it impossible for us to grow wheat crop, causing a major disruption to our operation. Due to this, we've been forced to buy feed for cattle and even sell some of our herd just to make ends meet. In California, 50 of the state's 58 counties are under a drought state of emergency. For that reason, Governor Gavin Newsom issued an executive order urging all Californians to voluntarily reduce water use by 15%. However, for farmers and ranchers, reducing water consumption is not as simple as turning off any sprinklers. There are no silver bullet opportunities to just use less water without sacrificing productivity and the livelihoods of people in farm communities, explained Jamie Johansson, president of the California Farm Bureau. He highlighted, while demand for water can be reduced, one thing will not change, and that is the public's demand for food. Considering California is currently responsible for the production of two-thirds of the nation's fruits and nuts, one-third of its vegetables, the strains on the water resources needed to grow these crops will be translated simply into a lower volume of food products going to the stores. At the end of the day, we have to stop thinking about what we're gonna do if there is simply not enough food to go around because things are going from bad to worse. With the U.S. growing fewer grains, fruits, and vegetables, major food chains are getting increasingly dependent on imports, mostly from Canada. The bad news, though, is that Canada is suffering just as much, if not more, from extreme dryness. In a recent report, local farmers revealed that a never-before-seen heat dome has literally burned their crops before harvest. Some fruit growers in the province of British Columbia said that the heat wave cooked fruits while still on the branch. BC Fruit Growers Association president and orchardist Pinder Dvalival said to the press, "It seems someone took a blowtorch to the fruit and just singed it." He described the cherries affected by the heat wave. They became brown in color with burnt leaves and dry stems. Dvalival also disclosed that 50 to 70% of cherry crops were damaged in that heat wave. Apples, apricots, and other stone fruits have also been damaged. "The overall financial impact is going to be great on the farmers," he added. Meanwhile, the corporate media is giving very little coverage about the severity of this crisis. The stories simply don't make justice to what is actually happening. And most importantly, no one is talking about the consequences this will have in all of our lives. It's hard to understand why the federal government isn't taking action to ease the impacts of this disaster. All over the world, several countries are also currently facing the consequences of the climate crisis, but other national governments are actively taking steps to turn things around. In Dubai, for example, a ravaging heat wave that sent temperatures above 122 degrees led the nation's technology experts to come up with a drone device that shocks clouds into producing rain. The United Arab Emirates has issued a multi-million dollar effort to tackle the blistering weather and bring up the annual rainfall average of the Middle Eastern country. And right here in the United States, we have a similar technology available for use. So why aren't we using it to mitigate this crisis? It does not make any sense at all. Our leaders are just lamenting, sitting, and waiting for things to magically get better on their own. In the meantime, we're heading into even darker times. Food prices have already been weighing upon our monthly budgets. You can rest assured that it's only going to get worse. Even billionaires in the food industry have been sharing their concerns about the frightening pace of inflation growth. In a recent interview with Fox Businesses, John Katsimatidis, the owner and CEO of Manhattan-based grocery chain Gristedes Foods, said that he expects 10% to 14% food inflation by October, and that Americans should brace for higher prices for basic expenses in the coming months. He said, "We're both in the food business, and we're in the oil business. Food prices are getting higher, and we expect even more increases by October. We're seeing anywhere from 10 to 14% by October the 1st. It's a real number." Now, when asked if businesses would pass higher costs to consumers, he answered, "You have to pass it on. Otherwise, you're not doing your duty to guard your employees or your company." In other words, what we have witnessed so far was just the very beginning, and there will certainly be much more financial and economic pain in 2022 and beyond. Despite rampant inflation, the Federal Reserve is not alarmed enough by the situation to the point of coming up with a plan to taper its aggressive stimulus measures. In fact, the central bank is currently buying $120 billion in bonds from the private market in order to pump even more liquidity into the American economy. That is to say, it's very unlikely food prices will ever be lower than they are right now. So, if you can afford to stockpile the supplies you need before prices have gone out of control, just do it while there's still time. Scientists are telling us that this is a multi-year mega drought, and what we've seen is just the tip of the iceberg. Unfortunately, there seem to be many more chapters to this story, and we must get ready for the looming disasters. Thank you very much for watching. If you found all this interesting, please check out 7-Year Apocalypse. It's the latest book of the economic collapse writer Michael Snyder. Please don't forget to share your thoughts in the comments section down below, and keep tuned for the next video.